Hello, today's video is on creating counter ads for media literacy. Like I mentioned in class, creating counter ads is not creating advertisements for countertops, it's creating advertisements that respond to advertisements. We're going to look at it as talking back to deceptive or harmful media messages by creating counter ads. So, counter ads are a parody of the original ads, and a parody means using a similar style to mock or ridicule something. So for example, look at the ad on the left is the original ad. Ad on the right is the counter ad. Ad on the left says, "Come to where the flavor is, come to Marlboro Country." Ad on the right, they've changed it just a little bit so it says, "Come to where the cancer is, come to Marlboro Country." Ad on the right is a counter ad responding to a harmful message on the left. Another example of a Marlboro counter ad would be this counter ad that someone made, "Welcome to Marlboro County," and it just shows people standing outside in a group smoking. Different from the image of the cowboy. So, countering, showing something. So, here's how to create a counter ad. Alter a real ad or like a magazine or newspaper ad. Those are some of the easiest ones to work with. You can change the text or add graphics over the original ad. You could even redraw one in the same style or layout of the real ad. You can also write parody scripts to act out or record. So if you wanted to make like a radio advertisement or a TV advertisement, you could write scripts for that and even record them. For example, adding text over an ad, here's a CoverGirl ad with Rihanna that someone has added. "Now, recruiting for airbrushing professionals must have experience in creating unattainable beauty." Kind of responding to the message of, or responding to the amount of airbrushing that happens in cosmetic advertisements. Here's another one someone wrote over, "Heaven forbid a woman should look her age," because the Nivea ad says, "Discover why millions of women don't look their age." And so they're responding to that idea that women shouldn't look their age. Here's some tips for creating counter ads. I'm going to go through quite a few of them. I'm going to try and go pretty quickly. You can always come back and check them out. Analyze. Look at why real ads are effective, because the best counter ads use those same techniques. Power. You need to break through the clutter of real ads, just like real ads try to break through the clutter of other real ads. So think about what makes an ad memorable to you. Think about what techniques does it use to grab your attention, and then use those techniques. Persuade. Use the same techniques found in the real ads, those same persuasion techniques, such as humor, repetition, flattery, and there's plenty more. Pictures. Visual images are powerful. People often forget what they read or hear, but remember what they see. And the best counter ads, like real ads, tell their stories through pictures. Rebellion. Advertising targeted at young people, so advertisements with a targeted audience of young people, often use the appeals to youth rebellion, showing that you're rebelling against something. Counter ads expose these methods and turn that rebellious spirit toward the companies who use them. So if there's a company showing some students, some young people being rebellious, making a counter ad showing that they're rebelling actually against the company that's advertising is sometimes an effective counter ad. KISS, KISS, keep it short and simple. Use only one idea for your main message and focus everything on getting that message across. Plan. Try to think of everything before you start, the words, the images, the design. Draw up some sketches or rough drafts before creating the final product. Practice. If you're making a radio or TV script, then rehearse it, and then rehearse it again. Teamwork. If you're working in groups, work as a team because it can lighten the workload and spark creativity. You could brainstorm ideas as a group to get more ideas and also share some responsibility. So make sure you're sharing that responsibility. Revise. When you think you're finished, show your counter ad to someone not involved with it. Someone else that's not working on the project as well, someone that doesn't really know what you've been working on, and see if they understand it. See if they think it's funny. Use their responses to revise your work for maximum impact. Distribute it. Your ideas are meant to be seen. Make copies of your counter ads and post them around your school or get them published in the school newspaper. Your counter ad could cause needed conversations about the media. And remember, last tip is to have fun. Making a counter ad is a fun way to learn about media. You can be creative, you can express your views, and enjoy it.